Hi, I'm Mr. Taru. In this video, we're going to talk about direct variation. Not joint variation, just basic direct variation with a lot of examples. So, direct variation is when y varies directly as x, or your textbook might say y varies directly with x, with a constant variation of k. So the equation, and anytime you see the word direct variation in your problem, you should just write y equals k times x. Just get that out of the way and not have to think about what the formula is and just stare at it as you do the rest of the problem and hopefully use it as well. Or take this equation and divide both sides by x and you get y over x equals k. So what you see here is that k means that you have a constant ratio between your corresponding values or coordinates of x and y. Y divided by x is a constant k. Now, this is called your constant of change, the k value, and your textbook will simply say that k cannot equal zero, but a lot of textbooks with direct variation problems, and maybe because it's the difficulty of coming up with word problems that have this scenario where most of your examples will have a positive constant value. So you might start thinking, and sometimes I slip up and say this if I haven't taught direct variation for a long time, where it's, as x increases, y increases. Well, that would imply that k must be a constant or a positive constant value of change. But simply, the textbook says, and it's true, that simply the restriction on k is that it cannot equal zero. So you can't have a constant that's both positive or negative. And unfortunately, though, you might forget that negative part because a lot of problems in textbooks have your constant value of constant value of change, your k values, as positive, but they can be negative. Okay, we got some examples here. We have three tables of values. This is usually when you first start learning direct variation, where they start working on making sure you can recognize direct variation. So we have these table of values, these x and y tables, and we just have to identify if these functions that these table of values represent, do they represent direct variation? Well, all you need is a constant value of k. All you need is that when you take y divided by x, you get the same ratio or same answer from that division over and over and over again. So here, a very simple example, we have 4 divided by 1, 8 divided by 2, and 12 divided by 3 as we divide our corresponding x and y values, and clearly these are all going to equal a ratio of 4. So example number 1 has a k value of equal to 4. All those y's divided by all those x's have a constant ratio, thus this does represent direct variation. This example here, where we have 9.6 divided by 3, 12.8 divided by 4, and 17 divided by 5, are all those going to be the same? Well, 9.6 divided by 3 is going to be 3.2, and 12.8 divided by 4 is also going to be 3.2, so we're looking pretty good so far, but 17 divided by 5 is going to be, see, how many 5's are in 17? 3 times 5 is 15, so that's going to be 3, and it's 15, so it'll be a remainder of 2, so that's 3 and 2 fifths. Well, 2 fifths is 0.4. So this table of values, this function, does not represent a direct variation scenario because we do not have the same k value, we do not have the same ratio for each of the corresponding y and x values. And then finally over here, we have 10 divided by 2, which is equal to 5. And now, I'm not going to check all these because clearly 5 divided by 4, that doesn't equal 5, it's actually 1 and 1 fourth. So, the only one of these functions that represents direct variation is the first table of values. Let's move on to looking at some equations and graphs and recognizing whether it's direct variation or not. First 4 examples. Now, over here we have 4 equations. Are they, each one of those, direct variation or not? Well, again, direct variation is y equals kx or y over x equals k. This is a more standard format, though. Well, let's see, what color chalk am I going to use? Here we go. y equals 2.3x. Y equals 2.3 times x. Well, y is alone. The variable x has a constant multiplication to it, and that's exactly the format we have up here, y equals kx. So this is direct variation. Again, your constant value of change, your k value, can be positive or negative. The only restriction is it can't be equal to 0. So we have y equals negative 3x. That is in the format of y equals k times x. So that's direct variation as well. Now here, we have y equals 4x minus 1. And if I were to take out the minus 1, that would be direct variation. But with the subtraction of a constant, which is not part of our, you know, formula for direct variation, means this is not. Whoops, I'm going to pick a different color there. So that's not. And then y equals 5 over x. Well, x is in the denominator. If I were to rewrite this to get the x out of the denominator, I don't know if you've studied this yet in your class, but if I want to take that base out of the denominator, this would become y is equal to 5 times x to the negative 1. So that does not match y equals k to the x because this has an exponent of 1, not negative 1. So whether you recognize that this pattern, this just the way this equation looks, doesn't match up with our general formula, or whether or not you whether you pull the x out of the denominator and you write that exponent of negative 1, either way, this is again not going to be direct variation. Now let's look at these graphs, and you know, which of these graphs represents direct variation? Well, excuse me. This is curved. This appears to be what's called exponential growth. What we're concerned with is we do not have a constant value of change between y and x. The graph is curved, which means that this, wouldn't necessarily look like y equals k to the x, but that we don't have a constant change in that graph. It's a curved graph, exponential growth, if you've studied that yet. So this would not be a visual representation of direct variation. Now, here we have a line, it's straight, so at least it's constant, that's good, because it is called a constant of change, and it has a positive slope, and it passes through y equals 0. Well, maybe by now you've done some graphing of lines, where when you have linear functions like this, the standard form that we graph in, or the most common form that we graph in, certainly not standard form, it's slope-intercept form, is y equals mx plus b. And if you've studied that yet, then you recognize that we have y equals, so it's y equals and then a slope times x plus b, or a y-intercept of b. Direct variation is almost the same format. Y equals our constant of change is our slope, and then x, we're good there, but there's no constant at the end, so our y-intercept and direct variation is equal to 0. We don't, when you add by 0, nothing happens, so we don't need to show that. So y equals k times x, that is, you know, the equation of a line with a y-intercept of 0. Well, this is a line, it's straight, it has a y-intercept of 0, so this is, yes, direct variation. How about a negative slope? Again, kind of missed the origin there, but it does pass through 0, 0. That is a constant value of change, a k value, which is negative, but it does grow through the origin, so its y-intercept is 0. So that is also direct variation, just with a negative k instead of a positive k. And here we have a line whose y-intercept is not equal to 0. Maybe this is y equals 1 half x plus 1. But the point is, this line is not passed to the origin, it does not have a y-intercept of 0, thus it is not direct variation. Okay, let's find my remote. Oh, there it is. Go on to the next example. Bam! So now that we can recognize direct variation, let's solve some problems that involve direct variation. These questions pretty much all work out the same. So we got some steps and we're going to work through three examples, the last one being a word problem. You're going to use the initial x and y variables, or the initial values given to you, to find the constant value of k, the constant value of change. You're then going to, or I suggest very strongly that you write out that equation, and with some question that's all you have to do, you're done. But if they go on to ask you, you know, to solve some further questions, use that equation to finish the problem. So let's just assume that these questions were already been told the directions, again, of course, represent direct variation. We might be just given one point and asked to come up with the equation for direct variation. I'm going to have to do that anyway to finish the question, which is use the equation that I come up with using this coordinate to find or solve for y. So we have, of course, when we're given a point, we're given an x and a y coordinate. So direct variation is y equals kx, and our y value is equal to 6. We're trying to solve for k with that initial set of coordinates that we're given, or a point, consisting of two parts. X is equal to 4, so k times 4, divide both sides by 4 to solve for our constant, and 6 divided by 4, they're both even, so they can both be divided by 2, so that reduces down to 3 halves, is our constant of change. So, step 2, write our equation out. Well, that means that our equation is y equals 3 halves x. All final equations, unless it's a vertical or horizontal line, should have both the x and y variables in that equation that represent these x and y values or variables represent all of the points that this function includes if you were to graph it. Now we're going to use this equation to finish the problem. Hey, what if x is 9? What would y be? Well, if x is equal to 9, let's just take this equation and go, okay, so for this part, y is equal to 3 halves times 9. Well, that's going to be 3 times 9 is 27, so it's 27 over 2. Quick check of my notes here, and we're good. Okay, so that's how you do direct variation problems. Give an initial value, plug them in, find k, write the equation, and then use the equation if necessary or asked for to finish the problem up. Okay, over here it says if y is equal to 16 when x is equal to 10, find x when y is 22. This question really is exactly the same as this problem, but sometimes when a book starts with just giving coordinates and it gets into a word problem, students get confused, or vice versa, but these really are the same question. So let's get this next example started. We have y is 16, x is 10, so again, direct variation, y equals kx, y is 16, solving for k when x is equal to 10, divide both sides by 10, and now 16 and 10, I want to keep this in exact form, you know, show you some fraction work. These are both even, so we're going to reduce this fraction by dividing both the top and bottom, the numerator and denominator, by 2, so it's going to be 8 fifths, and write the equation. So all of this work allows us to find a k value, which, or an equation, excuse me, which is y equals to 8 fifths times x. Now we're going to use that equation to finish the problem, which says find x when y is equal to 22. Well, that means we're going to take 22, plug it into our equation we just found, and get 22 is equal to 8 fifths x. We're going to multiply both sides of this equation. By 5 over 8. That's going to allow this to cancel out. 8 divided by 8 is 1. 5 divided by 5 is 1. So we get x is equal to, let me get a different color here. Now what's going on here? This is 22 over 1. So the 8 and the 22 are even. So I can reduce that a little bit. Divide both sides by 2. So 8 divided by 2, or 8 divided by 2 is 4. And 22 divided by 2 is 11. So, got a bit of a mess here, but we have 5 times 11, which is 55, over 4 times 1, which is 4. So we got one last example. It's going to be a word problem, and we'll be done talking about
direct variation.
Woo! Last example. Okay, the distance you travel varies directly with the time. If you travel 147 miles in 3 hours, how long will it take for you to travel 245 miles? Well, if you're studying direct variation, you will, of course you are because you're watching this, but as soon as you see varies directly, you should be going, okay, the distance traveled, distance traveled varies directly, so K varies directly with time. Oh, this looks familiar. Distance equals rate times time. Great. Okay, so if you travel 147 miles in 3 hours, how long will it take you to travel 245? Well, keeping up with the direct variation idea, plug in the y, plug in the x, or in this case, distance and time, solve for k. We're going to divide both sides by 3 and get k is equal to, let's see, 14 divided by 3, that's going to be 4. 3 times 4 is 12. Take 12 out of 14, you're left with 2, so 27. 27 divided by 3 is equal to 9. So we're going basically 49 miles an hour. Write the equation. So y is equal to 49 x, or distance equals, and then the k, I probably shouldn't do that. Let's put the words back in. Actually, let's do this. How about we just take this out? K is equal to 49. I'm going to need some extra board space anyway. And put the 49 in for K. How long will it take you to travel 245 miles? All right, so again, we're given a distance. So 245 is equal to 49 times time. Divide both sides by time. Excuse me. We're trying to solve for time. Divide both sides by 49. And time is equal to 5 hours. Now, before this video is over, let me just show you how direct variation does tie into and is similar to, actually, it's another version of equal proportions. You might look at this and go, okay, I know it says varies directly, but I've heard a lot of questions like this where I have a certain, I'm traveling a distance, I got a time, and now I'm given another distance. So I can look at this and go, well, what of these measurements would I prefer to put on top? Because with equal proportions, you decide what the pattern is. So let's just say, and it kind of makes sense since with traveling, distance over time. So when you read the first question, we have a distance of 147 over a time of 3 hours. Now, excuse me, we want to extend that to 245 miles over an unknown value of time. Well, we're going to cross multiply this and get 147x equals, and let me cheat off my notes here, 3 times 245 is 735. Divide both sides by 147. And x is equal to 5. Now, same answer as we had before. Now, I'm not telling you to ignore this direct variation idea of y equals k times x. I just, because it really is a better format for some of these questions, but I do want you to see there's a relationship between equal proportions and direct variation. I'm Mr. True. That's the end of our talk. Now, bam! Go do your homework.